Good morning, dear students. So let's talk about today's topic. And today we'll talk about the format menu. And there are some of the important topics, important tools which are in format menu and which are very, very useful for working with any word processing software. This section is basically dedicated to formatting the contents. So if you want to format a content, like suppose, for example, you want to change the color of text, you want to change the paragraph style or paragraph setting, or you want to insert bullets and numbers. So for all these purposes, we refer to the format menu, and some of them can also be done with the help of formatting toolbar. Like some of the tools from the format menu are available in the format toolbar. So we'll work from the format menu only. You can work similarly from the format toolbar also. First, let's talk about character settings or formatting characters. Characters means formatting the text that you have here. So for formatting the text, what we do is either you can select the text, first you can type the entire text and then you can do the formatting. Or other way is that you can set all the settings for a text that you are about to type. It will be applied when you keep typing. So I have already typed a content. I want to make changes on it. So you can simply select the text, and you know how to select the text by simply clicking and dragging the mouse, or there are myriads of the ways to select the text. So you can go to the format option and click on the character option. So when we clicked on the character option, there are some of the tabs available here: font, font effect, position, hyperlink, and background. Let's talk about the font. So font has again four sections here: font, typeface, size, and language. So first is the font. So what font you want to use? You can suppose Comic Sans MS, and you can see the output is visible here. Preview, you can see. What typeface you want? Regular, italic. Italic means it will come cursor. Bold, it will come darker. And if you go apply, want to apply both bold, italic, you can apply both. Or we can simply click on the regular option. And you can also increase the size of the text that you have typed by this. Click OK. So we have applied the settings over here. Comic Sans MS was the name of the font. You can do same thing from here. You can change the font name that you have entered. You can increase or decrease the size. You can make text to appear bold, italic, even underline, whatever you wish to do it. These were the normal effect. Format, again, let's go to the character option, and then we can go for the font effects option. So you can choose the color of text. You can either go for overlining. Overlining means a line will come over the text, and you can choose what type of lining you want. You can change the color of the overlining that you are putting. Some more effects you can put, like capitals, lowercase, title case, small capitals. This is the change case option or the case option for a text. If you go for lowercase options, all will come in small letters. If you go for capitals, all will come in capital letters. If you click on small capitals, all will come in a capital letters, but the text will be smaller. You can go with the strike through options. A strike through means a line will be drawn through a bit through the between of the text, through a bit from the between of the text. It's called a strike through. Okay, and you can go without this, and you can put some extra efforts, like you can go for embossed or engraved effects. You can make it blinking. If it doesn't work all the time, you can give with the hidden text also, or you can make it outline or shadow of a text. Let's see what happens with this. So this is the style that we applied to it, font style. Then we can again go to the format option and character option, and we click on the position option. So now text can be raised from normal to above at the power or at the bottom. We discussed this in the shortcut keys also, and we can even rotate a text by 90 degree, by 270 degree, or fit to line, whatever it is. And we can also give the spacing between the text by some space. So we have rotated the text, and we have also applied the space between the text. You can see the text has been rotated, and there is some extra space between the characters. Again, format and character option. Let's talk about superscript and subscript. Suppose you want to write any formula, like H, you want to write x square, so 2 has to be superscript. So I told you the shortcut key for that, Control Shift and P, that is power. Okay, Control Shift B for the base, that is subscript. Okay, so what we'll do, we can do the same thing from here also, format character, and we can click on the superscript option. You can relative font size is 50%, 60%. You can even decrease the size of the power that we are typing. Superscript, and similarly we can go for the subscript option. And next option that we have here is format character, and we have hyperlink. So if you want to make a text as a hyperlink, you can make it hyperlink also. Suppose I want to make this x2 as a hyperlink, so select it, format character hyperlink. You can browse the text. Okay, suppose I want to make this as the hyperlink for maybe certificate of packing or CVC presentation, for example. Open. Now the text will be a hyperlink, and you can follow hyperlink by pressing Ctrl and mouse button. Now when I clicked on this button, this particular text, you can see now that the content has been opened. So this has means this has become the hyperlink now. And other things that we can do with the text is insert hyperlink. From here also we could have done hyperlink. You can select the text, and the last tool here is called the background. So if you wish, you can change the background of the text, right? So background of the text can be changed as per your own choice. Fine. So this is how we can change the background of the text, and we can change the font color. So there are direct ways to do this also. This is the way how we can directly change the font color. We can change the background color of the text, or we can highlight a text. This is text highlighter. We can highlight the text with this. So this was the character font setting. And on my next lecture, we'll talk about the paragraph and bullets and numbering, and then we'll talk about the pages inserting, I mean changing the page setting. So that's all for today. Thank you so much.